What is the industry logic then for doing this deal?
Well, in a word, it's all about convergence. By combining these companies, that combines UPC Switzerland, which Liberty Global owns, with Sunrise, giving them basically almost a third of the market for the fixed broadband network. That allows them to compete in that space head-to-head with the giant Swisscom, the incumbent carrier. And it also allows them to compete more strongly in the cable TV industry. Now, that's an industry that's in contraction because a lot of television viewers want to jump to online, Netflix, that sort of thing. But if you are running a converged telecom company, you can benefit from that switch as well. So that's the logic behind this, is that it gives them scope across all three of those major businesses.
It's a pretty strong premium given how shaky the economic outlook has been. Why did they have to pay up so much?
Well, I think part of it is that the Sunrise's share price had been somewhat depressed because this is a deal that had been contemplated for another angle months ago. It was basically rejected when the idea was that Sunrise was going to buy UPC Switzerland, the unit of Liberty Global. So now it's kind of the other way around. You have Liberty Global buying Sunrise and combining the two that way. So after that deal had collapsed. Basically, the share price had gone down and dropped. If you look at this from the point of view of not the premium on the share price, but if you look at it relative to earnings, it's actually reasonably priced. You're at about 7.5 times EBITDA, and that's very similar to where you've got the giant Swisscom trades at about 6 times its EBITDA, its projected EBITDA. So it's within the range of what telecom companies are worth.